support the university. We reflect on the sacrifice and the hardship he endured and express our gratitude for the glory of his achievement. It is humbling for me to recall a newly elected president of the Banika Respect. This party would not have existed without Ganesh Manshi, K.B. Kwerala and Subhadra Samshi, K.B. Bhatta and Gita Prasad Kwerala. Without them, Nepal would not have had the kind of real democracy we are trying to foster today. We are its young soldiers of democracy. We were inspired by the story of Ganesh Manshi, who gave up a privileged life in an affluent Kadi family. He went on to lead two successful revolutions against the Lala family oligarchy in 1991 and the Panchayat democracy in 1990. Yet, when he was offered position of Prime Minister, he declined. It is this noble character of humility, sacrifice, and courage that is synonymous with the life of Ganesh Manshi. More than half of the Nepali population is under the age of 21. Our young citizens need to be told the story of Ganesh Manshi to remind them that freedom that we take for granted has came at a high price. It is for this reason that I appreciate the efforts Master Singh has made in chronicling his memoirs. He has brought the story to life so vividly that they read like a rich work of fiction. We are aware of the fact that while Nepali Congress is proud of its history, we can only thrive as a party of this future on the governed effectively a genuine result on the ground. Democratically elected, democratic election of 1959, Ganesh Manshi became the Minister for Work and Transport under the premiership of Kerala. He was a part of the most effective administration in Nepal's history. In less than 18 months, the Congress government initiated land reform, abolished the Pitra system, got rid of the small feudal principalities, launched first step towards industrialization, irrigation, tourism, established Nepal's first university. The foundation of the infrastructure of East Coast Highway started the cooperative movement and made a major tribute of this to the world community. We now live in a different era, but it is in the spirit of the progressive reform that has served on the benchmark whenever the Americans have yet come. Asked us to ensure that rural areas had food security and that citizens had access to decent shelter, sanitation, education and health. They insisted that all this should be done with the food engagement of the people. While they sound familiar today, they were advocating a participatory model of the development. Before
these ideas came into existence. Your Excellencies on the dais, as well as in the room, and all the distinguished guests for their kind presence at the launch of the memoirs of Ganesh Manshi, dignity. I hope these publications will fill a glaring vacuum in world literature on big struggles that are yet to be told and appreciated. We are a small country, but our tale of struggle against oppression was no less glorious than any other elsewhere in the world in modern times. I admit that it is not easy for me to be dispassionate when talking about my own father. And since speakers before me have kindly highlighted all the unique traits and character and what he means to millions of Nepalese across generations, I need not repeat them. What is striking, however, is the recurrence of common themes that describe Ganesh Mansingh. It is the virtues of courage, conviction, humility, foresight, and sacrifice that captures the essence of his life and character. There was never a hint of superficiality in his conduct of public or private life. His integrity was rock solid. It was indeed in recognition of these qualities that the people spontaneously referred to him as the Loha Purush. Like democracy in Nepal, Ganesh Mansingh suffered immensely with routine torture and imprisonment for life on several occasions. None of this intimidated him because he had the willpower to stare down kings and dictators. I often wondered where he derived his strength and freedom from fear. I now believe they originated in the core democratic belief he had that the source of all state power lies in the supreme sovereignty of the common people. In recognition of his monumental contribution, the United Nations gave him the Human Rights Award, and until his death in 1997, he remained the keeper of conscience, speaking up boldly for the marginalized and the excluded. I conclude by expressing my gratitude again to you all for partaking in this event as a mark of respect for Ganesh Mansingh on his 100th birth anniversary.
The honor or the joy of knowing the late Ganesh Mansingh ji personally. But anyone who has anything to do with Nepal knows about him and knows about his contributions.